Hello, all good citizens of the world. I'm going to give you the review, or our review, of the Helinox and the Nigor chair, travel chair today. First of all, if there's a bit of noise, apologies. We're in Sucre and there's wildlife roaming around here. We've been using these chairs for about 4.5 years. We started off with Walk Stool. It's a Swedish brand. It's one of those triangle chairs that folds up. It's beautiful. It's strong. It's bulletproof. But when you sit in a campsite for 3-4 days at a time, it's not fun. And it eats your balls, it eats your back because there's no backrest. So we eventually got rid of them in Africa. We just couldn't use them anymore. That said, this is about the only luxuries we carry on our bikes. But the thing is that when you travel, you sit in campsites, maybe 3-4 days, you camp at a beautiful place next to a river, to a lake. You can't sit on the ground all the time. You can't sit on the pannier box all the time. And you need to have a bit of a backrest. So these chairs for that kind of travel makes a lot of sense. We've also had the Monarch butterfly chairs. That didn't last. It swivels on two little, you have to balance yourself on two little things. That didn't work out. So eventually we've bought one of each. We've had two of them. I sent one back because it was too small for me. I bought one of them, one of the Nigors. And they're really good chairs. But let me explain to you. The Helinox weighs just under a kilo, which is 2 pounds, I think. It can carry up to 150 kilograms of body weight, men. And then it is about 33 centimeters in length. So it packs really small. It's easy to set up if you haven't most probably known with them. The poles are DAC poles, DAC, I think it's a South Korean company. The anodizing is a green, eco green type of anodizing. I'm not sure exactly how they do it. They say it's less, it's more environmentally friendly. It's shock coated poles, and these are nylon fittings that they use. And I can tell you that these nylon fittings are extremely strong. I have bent this chair, I don't know which pole it was, I've bent one of them. When we were sitting on mud and the chair went into the mud, so it bent the pole, and it was quite an effort to bend the pole back. The poles are made from a 7000 series aluminium, the same as with the Nigor chair, and this is where you need to focus. There's a lot of big retail stores selling similar chairs. You might pay $50 or $60 for them, or for something like that. There's a good chance you're going to buy another one. The secret of these chairs are in the poles and in the fittings that they use. That's what's giving them the strength. And unfortunately, with this kind of aluminium and the construction and the lightweight that they have to carry, you either get good quality or you get bad quality. And if you pay $50 for a chair or $40 for a chair, believe me, I've been in that game. You're not going to get the quality that you want. These chairs will most probably last us a lifetime if we look after them. And Nigor, I know for a fact, and you can change parts out of them. I'm not sure if Helinox can do that. But it's good quality fittings. They've also got this portion is reinforced. And after all the 5 years of use, and we use them quite a lot. I mean, we camp a lot, and some places have rubbish chairs. We just take them out at hostels and go sit in the garden with them. So we use them quite a lot. It's very easy to fit them. I cannot say anything bad about the Helinox. There's the pole that I bent. It actually took me quite a while to bend that pole back. But this is it. The Helinox is a very good all-round chair. It's good for medium-sized people. I think, although it can carry 150 kilos, don't bargain on that. At about 120, 130 kilogram person, you get a bit too big for the chair, literally. It's just not enough space for you to fit. And I mean this in a very good way. I don't mean it in a bad way. Please don't take me wrong. You get to a certain stage where it's not nice. I was 120 kilograms at one stage, I was bordering on it's just starting to get uncomfortable. Right, that is the Helinox chair. The other thing is that I have to explain to you is that the Helinox pouch has got daisy chains on the pouch. So you can hook it onto something, you can hook carabiners onto it. It's a nice using little bag that you get with it. And then what you do is you hook it there. Hook it there. And there you go. that is it. That's the Helinox. What the Helinox is concerned, you will not go wrong. It's about $100-$120, I think, for the chair one. There's lighter chairs. I think as an all-around chair, this is a much user-friendly chair than the really light ones, because you most probably use it at home, maybe use it on a camping trip when you go with a car or whatever, but as an overall usable chair, I think this is a nicer chair than the ultra-light one that they currently have. Nigor is a Dutch brand. They started manufacturing about 5 or 6 years ago. I bought this one because it's a little bit bigger than the Helinox, and I just fit onto it. I'm about 185, 187, and sitting on the chair, knee wise, ergonomically, it's a nicer chair for me to sit in. It works on the same concept, except Nigor does not use nylon fittings. They use 7 series aluminium right away through the design. I think from all the designs I've seen and we've experienced with people using them, this is about the best design I've seen, or construction and use of aluminium, is because this thing is incredibly strong. I think they rate this at 150 kilograms. I'm sure they can carry more. But again, saying that, if you're that size, these chairs are not going to work for you. It is just not sizable enough. It's not made for that kind of application. The Nigor one is about 47 centimeters long. Also weigh 100 kilo. Also weigh about a kilogram, just under kilograms. I'm not sure if Nigor is selling into the USA. I know they're selling in Europe and some other parts of the world. The same. They don't have daisy chains on the back. It's a normal back. But I mean, nothing wrong with it. They've also got the reinforced sides. This one has been with us about 6 months shorter, 5 months shorter than the Helinox. You can see the difference in size. So it's just a little bit bigger, a little bit wider than the Helinox. And for people, if you're going to about 185 upwards, you weigh maybe 80-90 kilograms upwards, I think the Nigor is a much better choice. So, well, that's about it. There's not much else I can tell you about it, except that there is other brands, like I think REI is making one. Decathlon, I think, has got one. But you need to do your homework on this very, very carefully. It's expensive product that you're going to buy, and if they fail on you, that's the first money you've thrown away. Then you're going to buy another one. But overall, for travel and for long distance travel and for camping and maybe even using this, I mean, we will not use old camp chairs anymore, even at home, even a 4x4, and we have the space. I will not carry those big chairs in my life again. They, no ways. These chairs are comfortable enough, they're good enough, and for a kilogram, it's about nothing. The only thing that I would say, and detrimental to Nigor, or not detrimental, just it's a less of a benefit to Nigor, the difference in height for the Nigor versus the Helinox is that for packing size in panniers, the Helinox makes is just that better than the Nigor, because of the length. The 47 centimeters sometimes doesn't fit into all the kind of panniers. It fits into ours, luckily, so, but the only difference, or the only negative, the cons I would give Nigor for this, is that it's a lengthier size. Maybe they can do something to make it a little bit shorter, I'm not sure, but then you have to sacrifice on the width of the seat. So overall, for me, I prefer the Nigor because of the size and the sit, but the Helinox, it's equally good. You cannot make a fault. All for the line downwards, the other brands I've seen, they're good ones. I just don't like them. And like the walk stool, which is a triangle stool, it's very uncomfortable to sit on. Even for 3-4 hours, I can't do that. It's very difficult. So as for travel chairs, these ones are good. You can, and I can recommend them with you for a clear conscience. They do work and it's good value for money. I'm not sure how the hell they make money, because if they sell it to you once, I mean, it's been lost a lifetime. So I'm not sure. And as Nico, you can buy replacement parts, so it's most probably something you buy for life. In any case, that's it. Go well. I'm not sure. I don't think I've left anything out of it. Stay safe. Go well. Ciao.